We all know that there's no table of contents for a SharePoint page. You either have to use the Markdown Editor Webpart, which I have a video for that, or use the Text Editor Webpart. And I also have a video for that one as well. Or you find one in the SharePoint store and download that and have somebody with admin privileges add it to the SharePoint app catalog, or you develop your own web part using the SharePoint framework. And again, you have to have somebody with admin privileges to add that your web part to the SharePoint app catalog. If you need to leave Microsoft, or if you'd like to leave Microsoft some suggestions, you can click on the feedback button here in the upper right. And then let's go make a suggestion. Let's click that button. And this will take us to a forum, and we can search for table of contents. And there's a few in here, but the one I'm going to show you, this one's over a year old. It doesn't look like it's been resolved yet. I'm not even going to guess as to why that is, but we all know that we don't have a table of contents web part in SharePoint pages. So therefore, I've made the decision to no longer put my documentation on a SharePoint page. Instead, I'll still use the SharePoint page, but it's going to be for like information, general information, phone numbers, stuff like that, that my coworkers need to have. But if I want to document something like a project, I'm going to use Microsoft Loop. And let me show you that. Now, Microsoft Loop is like a second brain. That's the industry term, buzzword. There it is, buzzword, for a document library of your notes. It's like Notion, Obsidian. I'm not familiar with all the other ones, but I like Loop. And one of the great things is it already has some pre-built components in it. And if I type a / which is the command lookup, you'll see here, there is a table of contents. This is going to loop over the entire page and find all the headings that I have in my page and then build out a live table of contents, a dynamic changing live table of contents. So anytime I add another header here, it is going to add it into the table of contents automatically. That is pretty slick. And that's what we've been asking for years in the SharePoint page. So again, from going forward, you have to have it. This is in the 365 family, but I believe you have to have a special license for it. So I'm not sure about what that is. This is a developer license, and I have it at my work. But I do know that on one of my other accounts, I do not have it because it doesn't meet the license requirement. So if you have the chance, the opportunity to use Loop, I highly suggest exploring this. This is a game changer for me. I will not use SharePoint pages in the same way. I'll still use them, like I said, but it's going to be on a limited basis. Everything else will go into Microsoft Loop. And with that being said, I can add other team members to this loop. They can add things to it. We can collaborate. You can take this, turn it into a loop component. Any one of these blocks, I could turn it into a loop component. And then I can put that on other pages and it'll automatically update according to this page, of course. And I can embed this loop component inside of a Microsoft Teams channel if I wish. I think Loop is the future of note taking. It's even replacing OneNote for me. It's replacing SharePoint pages. and it has built-in collaboration and built-in components. And there you go. I'm not going to ramble on anymore. I hope you found this interesting. Please subscribe and have a great day.